What is Merial? It is the convergence of decades of experience and expertise in pharmaceutical, vaccine, and veterinary medicine. The animal health division of Merck and Rhône Mérieux merged into what is now Merial in 1997. The merger created one of the world leaders in animal health. So, how has the animal health industry evolved over time? And what role does Merial play? To get a look at how dogs are cared for today, we paid a visit to Taylor. Despite his age, he's a sprightly, playful pet. He lives in Georgia, in the United States.
Hi, ducky.
Cat.
And a cow?
Cow.
How's the cow go?
Moo.
That's good.
At 11 and a half years old, Taylor is more than a pet. He's a member of the family.
Taylor was our first baby. We go to the vet at least once a year, and lately we have gone, he had an echocardiogram, so we've been twice this month, and he had his blood pressure checked. So every 4 weeks we will use the front line, and we'll put it on his back for the tick prevention, then we'll give him his heartworm pills once a month to prevent the heartworms.
We follow Taylor to Dr. Miller's office.
Good boy, you're wiggly.
I think people are viewing their pets not just as the dog we keep out in the backyard, but now more as the family member that stays inside and has his own bed and his own food bowls and has his own little medicine tray where he takes his pills every day. They're veterinary behaviorists, veterinary dentists, veterinary cardiologists, veterinary dermatologists, veterinary orthopedic and soft tissue surgeons, just to name a few.
Some diseases common in humans also affect dogs.
Good boy. A lot of new anti-arthritis medications have been developed for dogs and cats, things that never existed before. We also see a lot of organ failure. As our pets are living longer, we're seeing heart failure and kidney failure and other diseases that we're having to manage for the comfort of the pet.
Dr. Miller routinely vaccinates cats against rabies.
And we follow the American Association of Feline Practitioners vaccination mapping guidelines. So we give all of our kitty cat rabies shots.
Lundi, 10h, 10h30.
In France, we visited the offices of Dr. Chanlois, a veterinarian near Lyon, who explained how cats are cared for today.
Au revoir, bon week-end.
We're cleaning the cat's teeth. The buildup of plaque can cause the gums to recede.
Oui, ils sont là, tes bébés, t'inquiète pas.
Vous avez Have you dewormed them yet? Not yet.
Il va falloir vermifuger.
You'll have to deworm the whole family, the kittens and mom. The way people treat their cats has changed tremendously. Before, people kept cats mainly on farms to keep the mouse population in check. The cat's role was more utilitarian. Nowadays, a cat is a real pet, a member of the family in full standing. Before, when your cat died, you would just get another one. The new cat would hunt mice just the way the old one had. But now people have a lot of affection for their cats. They don't treat them the way they used to. If someone's cat is getting sick, he brings it to the vet, and we do what's necessary to heal the pathology. Like millions of vets and dog and cat owners, Dr. Chanlois uses Frontline to control fleas and ticks. What about horses? At the ultra-modern Grosbois Clinic, located outside Paris, Dr. Cord explained that horses, too, are becoming real pets, beloved members of the family. The horse has become a new family pet. Before, people kept horses either as a source of income, like race horses, or to rent out to riders or mounts for sports. Nowadays, people have a more emotional relationship with their horse, similar to the affection they have for a dog or a cat. The owner wants the best care possible for his horse, whether it be preventing disease with vaccines or worm medicine or curing problems. Nowadays, there's a strong demand for medical care and or surgery. Like all the veterinarians we met, Dr. Cord emphasized how his job has evolved. The vet's primary role today is to give the animal owner expert advice. Preventive medicine mainly consists in vaccination, shots for flu, tetanus, or rabies. Also, deworming is essential to prevent equine colic. Dr. Cord vaccinates horses against flu and tetanus. To protect them from worms, he gives them Equivalent Duo.
Alors, on fait 450 kilos. Ah, mon petit coco. Essayez de pas tout cracher.
Nowadays, we want our dogs, cats, and horses to get the same level of medical care as human members of our families. What about the health of livestock animals? In Araçatuba, Brazil, we visited a ranch which combines rangeland and feedlots. The rancher uses state-of-the-art livestock raising techniques. Most of the calves here were bred by embryo transfer.
Hi.
Merial helps this ranch owner develop and implement an animal health plan for his herd.
Sistema adotado.
4 years ago, with Merial's advice, we implemented a preventive treatment program. Now, the key problems in this region are brucellosis and parasites. Now, we made a study of the impact of cysticercosis on the sales of the animals. And it turned out that we were losing up to 35% of the sale price. So then, we decided to prevent the cattle to get to the edge of the river. Providing the cattle with clean water protects them from cysticercosis. To prevent all other worm infection, Gilberto uses Ivomec. We don't have specific data about worm infestation, but I'm sure that if we weren't taking action, we'd have a weight loss of 10 to 15%, at least. In the center of France, we visited a traditional ranch where Charolais cows are fattened chiefly on pasture land. Here too, disease prevention is the key to livestock health. Our cows are vaccinated before calving, and the calves are vaccinated right at birth, with a booster 1 month later. The size of our herd makes it too difficult to treat animals once they're sick. It would be too complicated, time-consuming. Prevention is so effective today, we have very little disease on the ranch. Years ago, when we vaccinated less, we'd lose a lot of animal if a respiratory disease spread through the herd. It's a big problem for the management of the ranch. If a cow is infected with parasites, she'll have problems calving and the calves will be healthy at birth. Studies have showed that the carcass of an animal with worms weighs 60 to 80 pounds less than average. In Italy, the region near Venice is one of the top dairy producing regions in the country. These cows give about 10 gallons of milk per day on average. Everything is organized around the well-being of the animals. Our primary parameter was to build a structure that guarantees the well-being of the animals. Then we tried to alleviate the summer heat problem by painting the roof white to protect against the sun. The stable is surrounded by shade trees. One of our top concerns was to position the structure on an east-west axis. That way, we can take advantage of the prevailing breezes. We installed movable partitions in the front of the barn.
Le due testate le abbiamo, diciamo, attrezzate con delle pareti mobili. Ci sono delle sonde.
When humidity and temperature reach a certain level, we have sensors that turn on fans. And then we have a sprinkler system to spray the cows when it's hot. Just like a refreshing shower. The new cow-friendly building has increased both milk production and animal weight. The production yield increased by almost 1.2 tons, from 9.6 tons in 2005 to 10.8 tons in 2006. We treat the cows for parasites because they can cause huge problems. The product we use is Eprinex. Eprinex is a formula that is ideal for dairy cows because it doesn't pass into the milk. In France, we met a hog farmer who was proud of the fact that he was one of the first to administer Circovac. This vaccine was developed by Merial to combat disease which causes weight loss in piglets, post-weaning multisystemic wasting syndrome, or PMWS. When PMWS struck our herd, there were large variations in weight and growth rates. We struggled with the problem for about 4 months. We could see that they weren't very healthy. The piglets varied significantly and there was pronounced wasting. Their immunity was deficient. We lost 100 of them. The veterinarian caring for the farm recommended Circovac, the PMWS vaccine, which is administered to sows. Which group is being vaccinated today? The sows at 90 days of gestation. 3 weeks before farrowing? Yes. I had two farms in my clientele that participated in the study. They vaccinated certain sows and kept control groups that weren't vaccinated. Well, as soon as you walked into the barn, you could see the difference. It was spectacular. The breeders told us this vaccine was a miracle drug. We're to prevent catastrophes, not to put out fires. In northern Italy, we visited a poultry farm, a turkey breeder. Here also, vaccination for the prevention of disease is vitally important. Certain diseases can be treated, others we have to prevent using vaccination. In the case of TRT or turkey rhinotracheitis virus, we vaccinate before it strikes. Same for hemorrhagic enteritis. We prevent the disease by vaccinating the turkeys.
E lo stesso con enterite emorragica si interviene con.
These birds are immunized against Newcastle disease at the age of 7 days.
Questi animali sono pseudopeste aviare.
The vaccine is poured into the drinking water.
7 giorni di età praticamente.
In the hatchery, TRT vaccine is administered by misting.
Rinotracheite, TRT.
Next, when the hatchlings are 25 to 30 days old, they're given a booster dose to prevent Newcastle disease.
Per la pseudopeste aviare.
What about the needs of poultry breeders on other continents? In China, we met an executive from Wen's Corporation. They produce 450 million broilers per year and have 20,000 employees and 30,000 farms under contract. Certain diseases are common. They increase mortality and slow down weight gain. So we can't assure the quality of the chickens. 10 years ago, the survival rate of our chickens was at 93%. Today, after having used Merial's vaccines and improving our organization, it can reach 96%. Wen's has a number of hatcheries where chicks are vaccinated against Merrick's disease before being delivered to the farms. The chicks are put in tunnels where they are sprayed with the vaccine against Newcastle disease. The fight to contain animal diseases that can spread, also called epizootics, is closely monitored by governments or international agencies because they are a threat to human health and the economy. For example, rabies kills 55,000 people each year. Today, the wildlife of some entire regions is practically rabies-free thanks to oral vaccination. We watched a campaign underway in Ohio in the United States. Bait containing the vaccine is dropped from airplanes. It is picked up and eaten by the wild animals, protecting them from rabies. In residential areas, bait is thrown from cars.
We've had great success using oral rabies vaccination to prevent the further westward spread of rabies.
An outbreak of foot and mouth disease can prompt the culling of tens of thousands of cattle. To avoid these tragic measures, states bordering regions where FMD is endemic vaccinate their herds, as we saw in Brazil. The campaign to fight foot and mouth disease was launched in 1969 so that our meat would be eligible for export. Many countries in Latin America, Asia, and Africa have adopted foot and mouth disease vaccination.